Assalamu alaikum. First of all, I want to thank you again for the lessons that you've given us. It was an amazing course with lot of information about artificial intelligence. I'm very happy that I could join the course after having some troubles, of course. And now we finished it. The last assignment is the only thing that's left, and the subject or the topic that I've chosen to talk about is technological unemployment. And this is something that isn't a common issue. I've read about it in different books, and it's a topic that it's commonly you can find it everywhere on the internet, and people fear about automation. So what I want to talk about is like the past, the current status or the current situation in the world, and the future. And I want to give my opinion about it, like what do I think about artificial intelligence, what do I think about where it's going to go in maybe 10 years, 20 years. So I'm going to firstly, what I've read, I want to talk about the past. So I've read about in 1890 that there was a great horse manor. So people used to travel by horses, transporting goods, food, clothes, etc. And then what happened, the streets of England were full of horse shit. So it was full, and there came a plague. Everyone went sick, and it was very difficult for people to live in such an environment at that moment. But they couldn't do anything about it because they needed the horses. They were not efficient. They were inefficient because they needed to have breaks. You needed like maybe not one, two, maybe three horses for one job. So it was not very efficient to have horses to everything, but they couldn't do anything about it. So after a while, what happened, the combustion engine was found out, so it was made, and that made the horses go away. So the people in England, in the UK, didn't need to have horses anymore. So what happened next is that people saw that an animal has a job, so like the horse was doing, let's say, a job, and people also have jobs. So in that time already the fear of automation started. So people started to think about what will happen if my job is going to be taken over by a technological product, like an AI product. And that, like, people started to fear more and more and more, and it kept going up over time. And there was a time where 30% of the people in USA had the fear of automation. So that's quite a lot, because if you know, America has quite a lot of people, so the population is quite big. So 30% of those people were they were fearing that their job might be taken over in the future. But I've read a couple of books. One is from Richard Muskay, and one is from David Muskay, and they talk about technological employment, and they they try to give a future view about what's going to happen with artificial intelligence, what is it going to be like in the future. So first of all, they talk about to like less the fear of people, and they tell about a gradual victory. What does this mean? They say that it's not gonna be like a big bang, like now every single job is going to be taken over by machines or robots or whatever, but they say it's gonna go slowly, like maybe every 10 years there's gonna be one big job that's gonna be taken over. So that means gradual withering. It's going to go very slowly, like in 10 years one job, maybe 20 years one job, two jobs, three jobs, and then it's gonna go sorry about that, it's gonna keep going like this till once in a time people stop making robots or machines or new technological products or innovative products. But let's talk about, is it bad or is it good that the jobs are going to get taken over? Because that's the issue that is talked a lot about online. You see people talking about, like, maybe my job is going to get taken over in a couple of years. What am I supposed to do? But let's look at the complete picture about AI and AI getting bigger and bigger and bigger. What actually happens in the economy? So that's also important. That's what I researched as well. So people like David Muske, he talks in his book about a pie that is large enough for people to eat from. And what does he mean by this? He means that AI, so new innovative technological products, they make the pie larger, 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 and it keeps growing. So the pie gets bigger, bigger, bigger. What does this mean? That more and more people are able to get a piece of that pie. So let's say if a pie is like a pizza, then maybe 10 people can grab from it. But if it's like an extra large pizza, then maybe 20 people can take a piece of the pizza. And the same thing happens with AI and new technological products. So attaining money, working, doing stuff with AI, so the economy is going to get stronger and bigger as well. So more people will be able to get some money. There will be less people that will be poor. So there will be some people that can come out of the poor zone and step into a little bit richer zone. But this doesn't always have a positive outcome, or it also has a negative outcome. So let's say the poor people get a little bit richer, but this also means that the rich people will keep getting richer, 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 richer. So the one who has the possibility to grab a big piece of the pie, he can grab a bigger piece of the pie. And this also changes for the students. Like when a student goes to school, he has some future views, like I want to be, let's say I want to work in a fabric, I want to work with cars. And then there will be a time where that job doesn't exist. So the purpose of a child, so like his dream work, he will have less choices in the future. But that just doesn't mean that there won't be new jobs, but the new jobs will always be something with technology. So something with machines, something with AI, something with robots. And a lot of different jobs won't exist anymore. So the purpose will get less. Also, the inequality of the people, so what I told you, the rich will be rich and maybe get more richer, and the poor people, some of them can get rich, but the poor people will stay poor and get maybe more poor. And also, this is almost the same thing about like inequality, that's power. The one with a lot of money will all, of course, have a lot of power. And the same is with the poor people who don't have a lot of money. They don't have that much power to withstand against the rich people. So this is my opinion, like what I've researched, and I based my own opinion about it, that AI systems, new innovative products will for sure make the pie bigger in the future. The economy will go up, and countries will do good in front of other countries. AI systems make less mistakes, so that's a bonus as well. And also, people will have less work. So let's say that the purpose, what I talked about, the job options will get less. So that's something that will happen in the future. Of course, there will be new jobs, but those will always be something with technology. So it's not gonna be work in a fabric or taxi driving. It's gonna be a complete different thing. So my opinion is that it's good for the future. So it's good for the people that there are new innovative products coming up in the future. But it's gonna be very bad for a couple of people and very good for a couple of people. And and that's what the future is gonna bring. So I hope I talked a little bit more than 5 minutes. It's like double 10 minutes. I hope you don't mind. So it was a short presentation, a short talk about technological unemployment and my opinion about it, and about the books that I've read. I hope you enjoy it. I probably have said things that you already know, but even though I hope I've told you something which reminded you again and refreshed your mindset, and I wish you a good evening. Assalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.